Today we're going to learn about surds. So what is a surd? Well, a surd is a type of square root which is used when exact calculations are required, like in complex engineering calculations. A surd is used when the square root of a number cannot be written in an exact form. Not all square roots are surds. For example, the square root of 1 is exactly 1. This is not a surd because the square root is an exact number. But the square root of 2 is 1.4142 and so on. To substitute this into a mathematical calculation is awkward. Often we round this to fewer decimal numbers, like 1.41 or even 1.4. But those are only approximations, they are not exact. Approximations are not exact enough for complex engineering calculations, so we write the square root of 2 as it is. Writing this as the square root of 2 assumes that it has the exact value with all of its decimal numbers, without the inconvenience of having to write all of them. And it's not an approximation. Just like the square root of 2, the square root of 3 is 1.7320 and so on. It is also written as a surd, which assumes its exact value with all of its decimal numbers and without the inconvenience of having to write all of the decimals. The square root of 4 is the exact whole number of 2. It's not a surd. The square roots of 5, 6, 7, and 8 are surds. The square root of 9 is the exact whole number of 3, so it's not a surd. Working with surds is not difficult, but it does require a different way of thinking and writing. Let's learn how to simplify surds. We'll do a few examples. The first example is to simplify the square root of 24. First, find the factors of 24 where one of the factors is a square number, like 4 or 9 or 25. Well, 24 is 4 times 6. The factors of 24 are 4 and 6. So the square root of 24 equals the square root of 4 times 6, all inside the square root symbol. Now the square root of 4 is the exact number of 2, so we can take that outside of the square root sign and put it in the front. But the square root of 6 is not exact, and we leave that as a surd. So to simplify the square root of 24, we write 2 multiplied by the square root of 6. In short, we say root 24 is 2 root 6. Now let's simplify the square root of 18. First, we find the factors of 18 where one of those factors is a square number. 18 is 9 times 2. 9 is the square number. So the square root of 18 equals the square root of 9 times 2, all inside the square root symbol. Now the square root of 9 is the exact number 3, so we take that 3 outside of the square root sign and put it in front. But the square root of 2 is not exact, and we leave that as a surd. So to simplify, the square root of 18 equals 3 multiplied by the square root of 2. In short, we say root 18 is 3 root 2. Now we'll do the opposite of simplifying. We'll find the entire surd. Let's write 2 root 5 as an entire surd. Well, first we square the 2 at the front. 2 squared is 4 and goes inside the square root symbol. Then we multiply what's inside the square root symbol. That's 4 times 5, which is 20. So 2 root 5 written as an entire surd is root 20. What's 5 root 2 as an entire surd? First we square the 5 at the front. 5 squared is 25 and goes inside the square root symbol. Then we multiply what's inside the square root symbol. That's 25 times 2, which is 50. So 5 root 2 written as an entire surd is root 50. Now let's multiply surds. What is 2 root 3 multiplied by 5 root 3? We'll do this a long way. 2 root 3 becomes the square root of 4 times 3, which is root 12. And 5 root 3 becomes the square root of 25 times 3, which is 75. Then root 12 times root 75 is root 900. The square root of 900 is the exact number of 30. But we can do this same question a much shorter way. We can multiply the 2 and the 5, and then we can multiply root 3 times root 3. That's root 9, or the exact number of 3. The same answer of 30. Let's simplify 2 root 5 multiplied by 5 root 2. Again, we'll do this a long way. 2 root 5 becomes the square root of 4 times 5, which is root 20. And 5 root 2 becomes the square root of 25 times 2, which is 50. Then root 20 times root 50 is root 1000. Now 1000 is 100 times 10. The square root of 100 is 10, so the square root of 1000 becomes 10 root 10. But we can do this same question a much shorter way. We can multiply the 2 and the 5 to make 10, and then multiply root 5 times root 2 to make root 10. So we get the same answer of 10 root 10. Now let's divide surds. What is 8 root 5 divided by 2 root 5? Notice that the root 5 is on the top and on the bottom of this fraction, so we can divide them. We divide root 5 on the top by root 5 on the bottom. What's left is 8 divided by 2, so the answer is 4. Let's do a more complicated question. It's not harder, it's just longer. What's 7 root 6 divided by root 3? Notice that root 6 is really root 3 times 2. So root 6 is really root 3 times root 2. Now we divide root 3 on the top and root 3 on the bottom of the fraction. What's left is the answer. It's 7 root 2. Now we will simplify a fraction where the surd is the denominator on the bottom of the fraction. Let's simplify 3 divided by root 2. Okay, here's a useful tip. Multiply the top and the bottom of the fraction by the surd that's on the bottom. The top of the fraction becomes 3 root 2. The bottom of the fraction is root 2 times root 2, which is just the number 2. So the answer is 3 root 2 divided by 2. Let's simplify 5 divided by root 3. Again, the trick is to multiply the top and the bottom of the fraction by the surd that's on the bottom. The top of the fraction becomes 5 root 3. The bottom of the fraction is root 3 times root 3, which is the number 3. So the answer is 5 root 3 divided by 3. Thank you for watching this video.